Good evening.
Good evening.
And thank you, everyone, for being here. First of all, just to express gratitude to all of you all that are here, and even for those that have traveled many miles to be here, and even those that may have traveled just down the road to be here, we're blessed because you are here. As you know, we are now officially members of Team Angelique. And part of being a member of that team is supporting Angelique. This is a very happy occasion. Number one, she has a birthday that's coming up very, very soon. Yes. And we know that with that, for Angelique, coming up on this birthday has not been easy. And so one of the things that we want to do as her support team is to celebrate with her today. And again, we thank you for being here. There were many others who wanted to commit to being here. For whatever reasons, they could not, but they committed in other ways. So we want to definitely think about them as well. Now, part of what we will do this evening is that we have special friends here to sing a couple of Angelique's favorite songs. And we also have a very special friend that will say a few words for the occasion this evening. And after that, if any of you all want to speak and talk, we will have that open forum. So I will ask for our special friends to come up and start lead us in song this evening.
Team Angelique, woohoo!
Good evening, Ms. Angelique. My name is Gloria Watson, and I am a friend of a friend, which is Angelique Mitchell. And I can't help but go to church on this because a year ago myself, I had a break in my neck. They told me I wasn't going to make it. But I want to say to you, you don't look like your story. And I'm so happy to be a part of this today, okay? And a little bird told me that this is one of your songs, so I'm going to try to sing a little bit of this for you.
Would not have made it.
I'm glad to say, Lord, you were right there. Lord, I'm stronger now. I'm so wiser. I'm so much better. If you had been there with me, God, I don't know how I could have made it, but I'm standing here today to say that I'm never, that I'm so stronger, I'm so wiser, I'm so much better. Angelique, I'm so glad you're here to let you know that we need you today. Oh, I want you to know I never could have made it. That's why I'm wiser right now. And I'm so much better. Oh, I know it was God that kept you through it all. And I'm here to say, we're so glad that you're here, that you made it. Oh, you made it. Oh, I never would have made it. No, I never could have made it without you. We're so glad that you're here, and we love you today. We thank God for your life. You had to fight a hard fight, but thank God you held the faith. And we gotta say that you held on, and you never would have made it without your faith in God today. And we love you, and we appreciate you for hanging in there when you felt like giving up, when you felt like throwing in the towel. But we gotta say, we love you, Angelique.
Thank you.
And thank you so much.
At this time, we're going to have just a few words of encouragement from our good friend, Stacy Carmichael.
Woo woo!
My name is Stacy Carmichael, and Angelique is one of my dearest friends who I've known for quite some years. And when Sonya asked me to speak for today, I was like, oh gosh, what am I supposed to say? Because everybody who goes through cancer has kind of a different journey, but then I realized we all have the same fight. And that is to achieve the same goal, which is to beat cancer, ultimately. So with that said, I decided I'll just share a little bit of my journey, briefly. February 25th, 2010 was a date, or is a date I'll never forget. I was diagnosed with stage 3A Hodgkin's lymphoma, which is a blood cancer. And prior to that diagnosis, I think I was more terrified than when I actually received it. And after I was diagnosed, I realized that, I didn't realize that at the time, I didn't get angry and I didn't cry, because I think the biggest determination for me then was that I gotta beat this. And failure was not an option. And losing a battle was not an option. It was not in my vocabulary to do. So I remember I was asking the doctor, what do we do next? And he said, you know, we have these rounds of chemo, whatever. And I had been in the hospital for a couple weeks, and I said, well, I want to have my first round before I leave. And so I did. And after that, I continued my journey, enduring 8 months of chemotherapy, going through the hair loss, several days of nausea, and being so sick that you just, I couldn't get out of bed. And just not wanting to move, and just like almost feeling like you wanted to give up because you just, you know, you just can't do anything. It's just awful. So with that, I finished up with 20 sessions of radiation. And from that point forward, it's been 3 years and 5 months, I am cancer free. But through everything, and I know Angelique will feel me on this, being positive and keeping a positive attitude, well, for me, it seemed to come very easy. And all this time, I really never thought, you know, where is this calmness and this positivity coming from? Like, because if anybody who knows me, I'm not that type of person. I'm always a worrier and always, you know, like freaking out about stuff. And it's just like, it just overcame me at that time. And, but really the reason for this and the determination that I had in the beginning was that God was in my driver's seat from day one. And through God, all things are possible. And I'm a true believer of that then, but now more than ever. And even with that, I can't leave out the support and the power of prayer that I receive from my friends, my family, near and far, and from people I didn't even know. But behind God, my main supporter was my wonderful husband, who gave me unwavering support when I know it was so difficult for him to watch me fight that fight. And for that, there's so many other reasons I will always love you. But all of these things and many, many more were part of my journey. And Angelique is now traveling through her journey with battling colon cancer. And just so you know, supporting her in any way that you can, whether it's through prayer, bringing food, you know, phone calls, whatever it may be, all of those things will help her and give her the ability to continue to fight her fight. Because hearing the words remission, as I'm so glad we've heard it for you, is such a blessing and a relief. But we know the fight is not over. The fight continues for Angelique. It continues for me and many others. And I do pray every day that God will continue to bless Angelique and give her the same strength, faith, and courage that he gave me, if not more. And I love you, Angelique. God bless you and all of you in this room today. And just, I just have a quick poem that I want to read to you guys that kind of sums up how I felt going through my journey. This is a poem written by another cancer survivor who survived breast cancer that I found that touched me. And I think it may touch you as well. It's called A Gift. I was given a gift, wrapped shabbily. It was non-returnable and non-refundable, but reluctantly I accepted it. In it I found courage I never knew existed, and patience far beyond anything ever experienced. I was given the ability to trust a stranger with that most near to me, and an endurance for the unknown. I was given unconditional love of family and friends, always there, never stopping, never faltering. I was given many prayers from far and wide, and the warmth of knowing I am truly cared about. I was given the fond farewell of my modesty and my vanity, and the acceptance and love of an imperfect body. I was given a strong shoulder to lean on, laughter and good times, more special than ever before. I was given warm sunshine and beautiful green grass, blue skies and sparkling city lights. I was given things to see that I once before ignored. I was given the chance to wake up instead of sleepwalking through life. I was given every glorious day to enjoy, every month to savor, and every year to rejoice in God's glory. I was given the gift of life. I was given cancer. That's all I have.
Okay, at this time, we want to open the floor to anyone that want to speak. Doesn't have to be a speech. You just want to let Angelique, I should know that name. If you want to just let Angelique know how much you love her, this is the opportunity to do that. Anyone?
Oh my goodness.
We feel you, girl.
Scorpios require.
Angelique, stand with me. I need your help. Angelique, I've known her for years. I don't even know how many years. But she is one of the dearest friends that I have. I appreciate you for everything you've done for me. You're such a I would say an unselfish friend. You give to everybody. And I want you to understand today is about you. And I want you to continue to take this and do things for yourself. Because we all love you and we appreciate the things that you do for us. But we want you to do things for you. I mean, you're always going to get your hair done because you do. You're always going to get your nails done because you do. Now, you do that. But I'm just saying, like, just things for you. You know, you love your kids. We know that. Everybody knows that. You love your family. We know that. You love your friends. But just do things for you. And we just want you to know that this is for you. And this is an honor for Angelique. We appreciate everybody for coming out today. And spending like your Saturday, because you know Saturdays are special, and the best man holiday came out this weekend. So we appreciate you coming out and celebrating this day, you know, with us. And I just love you, and I love all the friends in the room. I love you, Stacy. Stacy was our first friend who was diagnosed with cancer, and we felt like, oh my God, what are we gonna do? We were young, you know. We felt like, what is this about? But you know, like, Stacy beat it, and now Angelique can beat it. Hey. Oh, yeah. I love that. So, you know, I love you, and I love everybody for coming out, and I appreciate you. And you look so pretty today. Thank you. And like, I think, am I the first one to speak?
Yes. Okay. Anyone else?
Anybody else want to come up? But if not, you want to take a picture? Okay.
Oh, God.
So let somebody else come up. I love you. That's all.
Too.
I want to play computer.
No.
So, Angelique and I we actually met in high school. And even though we had mutual friends, we didn't really click in high school where, you know, we hung out all the time, but we were friends. But when we went away to college is when our relationship really formed. And she's my best friend. She's like a sister to me, and I love her. And we've been through so many things together. We've fallen out. That's what best friends do. We didn't speak for a whole semester in college. And we had a class together, and people were like, isn't that your best friend? So we would roll our eyes at each other and, you know, come in the room and not say anything. And it was the funniest thing because it was so painful and hard for us to do, but we were both stubborn, so we were like, we're not talking. The last day of class, I'll never forget it, the last day of class of the semester, when I walked out of the building, she was outside, and we just cried. That's all we did, because we were like, you know, you're wasting your life. You don't realize it then, but petty things make you stop talking to people and communicating with them. And we realized that even at our young age that it was not that important. And we've never fallen out like that ever again since then. And we've always been in touch. And even when she moved to Atlanta, we stayed in touch. And she's very sensitive. And so when she got this diagnosis initially, you know, she wanted to be strong for the kids, but I let her cry. And I let her get it out. And I cried too. I tried to be strong for her when we would talk on the phone, but when we got off the phone, I would cry because I couldn't imagine what it was like for her being a mother, getting that diagnosis and having small kids. And the selfish part of me was like, what are you gonna do? I'm like, I'm not the one fighting the fight, but I couldn't imagine my life without her. But I'm so glad that we serve a God who is a healer. And he says that if we ask, that he'll give it to us. And I prayed for you like I never prayed for anyone, probably not even myself. And I'm so glad that he healed.
Friends, we've had a lot of great times together, a lot of partying times together. Yes. So we're going to flip this in just a few minutes and make it a party. But before we do, Angelique, I want to let you know that all of your friends and family that's here and friends and family afar support you. And not only in prayer, but they have supported you financially. Team Angelique raised $500. For you, and just as Trina said, it's for you. Mm-hmm. You know, it was very easy for people to give because you give so much of yourself. And even as we had an opportunity to purchase t-shirts and support you, we still have contributions that are coming in today. So just to let you know, it's for you. Now, like I said, we are going to turn it around. As if y'all didn't know, she's a party girl too. So within all of it, well, used to be, we're gonna crank this back up right now. Oh yeah, we know how to wobble, wobble, shake, shake. So for everyone that's here, please enjoy refreshments. We have a dessert buffet, so that everyone can get their sugar high on as we get ready to party and celebrate Angelique in this joyous occasion. And again, we want to thank God that you're here. Most importantly, thank God that Angelique is in that, what's that word?
Remission.
Remission. All right. Okay, so let's get this party started.
Well, she want to get the party started. Hey, what y'all need to do? You know how y'all do.
Smile.
Come on.
I don't know how to
do it. I'm going to get back.
I know.
Come on.
Yes.
Yeah!
Why y'all have a
all the way to go? Let me go.
glad to be here to share this moment with you. You made a milestone from the time you started with this. It's been a long road, I know, for you, but you know, I hope I've been there to help support you through all of this. Your spirit has been uplifting, and you've inspired me a lot. I love you, and I'm here for you always and forever.
Angelique, it's a blessing. We've said a lot of prayers for you, and we thank God for you. There's a reason why this is happening. It's just God's blessing, and you have a lot more in store for you. So, you know, God heals like no one else. So we're glad to hear that wonderful news. Keep doing what God needs you to do, and everything is going to be just quite well. So congratulations. Take care of yourself, and we're still going to continue to pray for you. And best wishes.
And happy birthday.
Oh, happy birthday. Okay, cool.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, Angelique. It's me. I just want to say that you have been fighting a very courageous fight. It's been a long time coming, but you've made it through. I just wish you many blessings, continued success, growth, and I just love you so much. Can't wait to see you.
It is Chelsea. I just want to say you have been such an encouragement. We've seen you go through this process, and you've been so strong. We're so proud of you. Such a blessing to watch you go through this process and see people smile on your face. But we love you, and I'm so glad that you're here with us.
Bye.
All right, thank you, guys.
Angelique, if I use one word to describe you, it would be inspirational. You inspire me. I know that we haven't gotten a chance to see each other much lately, so I feel that I'm following your life on Facebook. However, I mean, you're just always so positive and just so inspiring and just a great mom, a great friend. You've always been there for me, and I just want to say I appreciate everything that you've done for me, and I appreciate you just having my back when I've needed it. So, happy birthday. And continue to do all the things that you're doing. And you know what I always say, rest, rest, and more rest. And just remember that somebody in Alpharetta named DB loves you, because I'm part of Team Angelique. Love you, Angelique.
Hi, Angelique. I'm Gloria Watson, and I'm here to celebrate your life. And this celebration is just so wonderful to be here to celebrate you. We ask God to continue to bless you with many, many more years of your life. And we want you to know that we're here to say congratulations and many, many more years. And we love you.
Hi, I'm Gloria Watson. I just want to tell you to keep your faith.
And I'm Leo Watson. I'm her son. And I want to tell you, we love you unconditionally. Thank you for keeping. Thank you for keep going.
Hey, Angelique. I just want to say that I'm so extremely happy for you for coming through this journey on a positive note. My prayers have been with you through this whole thing, and you know I know what you've been through, but everybody's different, and I'm just really happy that you're still here to be with us today, and hope to be for many more years to come.
Hey, Angelique, this is Brad. I just want to wish you good luck with your journey. Of course, this hits home with us because, you know, Stacy is a cancer survivor. So we just want to say stay positive, keep some good support in your life, and you'll make it through this. God bless.
Love you.
Bye.
Happy birthday, Miss Angelique, and I love you a lot, and I'm glad that you're in remission and getting better. And, yeah, that's it.
Hey, Angelique, girl, I am just so happy for you. God bless you. Happy birthday, and happy to long life, and God is good, and take care, and you're my bestie. Love you. Bye-bye.
Hi, Angelique. I'm so excited to be here today to celebrate your victory over cancer for the second time. You have such a beautiful spirit, and I knew that when this challenge came to you that you would be able to overcome it, and I just want you to know that I love you very much, and that I know that no matter what comes your way, you can defeat it. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Angelique, you know we love you. We're blessed to have you here.
Ditto. You know we love you.
Sleek. All right.
I always knew you'd always be here. I'm so grateful to have you. I just didn't think anything would ever happen. I'm not making any sense, but you know I love you. I love our children, our grandchildren, my grandchildren.
She got an upside down.
Oh, I'm looking in the wrong place. I don't know what to say, you know. I'm just so happy that you're here, and I always knew you would be here. You never leave us, and you won't leave your grandchildren, my grandchildren, alone with me. They'd be spoiled rotten. Oh, I'm not good at this, but he told me I had to say something. I love you.
No,
I always have, and
that's
I always
what you got.
Will.
That's what the camera sees. So.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for giving me beautiful grandchildren.
You be cropping and photoshopping.
And for fighting. That was real important to me. I knew that all you had to do was fight and you'd come out a winner. Thank you. Love you. Bye. You make me cry now.
Well, Angelique, it's been such a long time since I've seen you. It's nice to see you. And I'm just happy. When I heard the news, I prayed and prayed and prayed. And I'm happy to hear that you're in remission. And may God continue to bless you and your family.
Hi, Angelique. It's Rohanda. Well, I want to say that I'm extremely happy that you are recovering from your cancer. God is an awesome God, and I want you to know that I love you. You're in my prayers, and thank you for being my daughter's other mother. Take care.
Mwah. Okay. Hi, Angelique. This is Trina, of course. I just wanted to say that I love you. I wish you well. I appreciate you as a friend. You know, I'm camera shy, so it's like all in my face. But anyway, I appreciate you. I love you. And Team Angelique.
Got you then.
Hi, Angelique. Just want to tell you how much I love you. I'm so happy to be able to celebrate this day with you. Just like we've celebrated so many times in the past, but this day is even more special. Knowing your battle, knowing your journey, Angelique. I love you, and remember to always keep God number one in your life. You can do all things through Christ that strengthens you.
Hi, I'm Soraya, and this is Little Mac Hall. We're representing the Hall family, and we just want Angelique to know that we really love you, and we celebrate you, and we know that God's will is perfect. So we'll be praying for you, and we look forward to many happy occasions like this in the future. Bye.
What's with the peace sign?
I'm not a point.
Make a toast to mommy.
I love you. Thank you.
I love you. Thank you. What else?
Thank you for fighting for cancer.
Yeah. For you. I fought for you. Cheers.
I love you, mommy. I'm glad that you fought for cancer.
Hi, Mom. I'm so happy that you're still here. I know you fought this the past couple years for me and Carrington, and I just want to say thank you so much, and I love you, and I can't imagine, you know, being alive without you, and it means a lot that you're still here.
I love
Anything
you.
Anything else to say? I say love you at the same time. 1, 2, 3.
I love you,
Mommy.
Okay. Okay. I would like to thank each and every one of you for taking time out of your day to spend with me, my kids, during this happy time in our lives. Everybody knows I just got my remission tag, if you will, a week and a half ago, so I am very, very blessed and grateful for all of your prayers, your thoughts, you know, coming to sit with me during chemo. I've had people bring over food. I've had helping me clean the house, look after the kids. Without you all, I could not have survived this battle. I know God is first, but without each and every one of you, it would have been an even more difficult battle. But I'm grateful. My mom, my dad, my stepmom, stepdad, my two children, Camden and Carrington, which ultimately gave me my best reason to fight. because I couldn't imagine you all living in this world without me. All the friends, my best friend. My best friend came from all the way from Austin. My parents, my stepmom and dad came all the way from Illinois, and my brother. I just can't thank you all enough for being a blessing in my life. So for that, I say thank you.
All right, thank you.